For the Christian students, discipleship, we use a lot of the same material that we would use in VBS here in Canada, and Wycliffe's material, Truth Quest, or others, so forth. There's also Soul Seekers, which is an after-school Bible club, which allows two things, not only for the students to have a little bit broader discipleship program with arts and crafts and games and so forth, kind of like a camp experience in some ways, but as well, the high school students who are going on a mission trip, they get to teach the Soul Seekers kids the program that they're going to take with them when they go on the mission trip. So, for instance, our mission teams go to the Philippines or to China and so forth. Well, they'll have like a VBS-type program and in Manila. And so what they do is they practice that material with the Soul Seeker kids in Korea. They kind of go through it and get used to it and all that. And when they go on the mission team, mission trip in March, they're already ready for you know, what kind of things will arise from that. There's some of the high school students in the back here with some of the Soul Seeker kids. We had a service project. I won't take too much time, but basically we were able to collect a lot of coins. They sent money to the Philippines, sent money to Honduras. We had a lot of contacts in Honduras. There was a school in Honduras, literally at the city dump. The school was at the city dump, about 100 kids at the dump school, and that's not uncommon in many third world nations. And so with our contacts in Honduras, we said, well, listen, we've got the school going here, the service project in Korea. Would you take this money and buy school supplies and buy shoes for the kids? So back home, we asked our students, Carol asked our students, to go for a day without shoes. Good experience to let them feel what it was like to be without shoes in another country. And that was kind of a fun thing. Special emphasis week or spiritual emphasis week happens in the fall for the elementary school. For the middle school, high school, it's in the spring. And we always bring in speakers for that. They have a whole week of special meetings. Right at the end of school, just to keep Carol from getting bored, they had one final VBS for the last few days of school, and this year it was on Bible principles, but taken with some kind of a little bit of a flight school theme. What are the things that cause us drag in our Christian walk, or hold us back, or prevent us from really getting off the ground, things like that. So they had a lot of different plane-related themes that way. In the high school, I have about 100 students on a regular basis, and I teach systematic theology to all the grade 11 Christian students. And we basically work through Grudem's book, which is a solid evangelical systematic theology book. And then for my Oasis students, I have philosophy classes. Well, you might say, well, philosophy? Well, you know, there's a lot of things in the philosophy curriculum that can point towards God. Plato and Aristotle, they always talk about the prime mover. Something got everything going in this universe. The first cause, the prime mover, and so forth. And when you get to the medieval period, people like Augustine, Anselm, Aquinas, you know, Christian philosophers. Very, very influential philosophers. We study them in our Oasis class. So I have many opportunities, even though it's a philosophy class, I have many opportunities to share Bible material because it's part of the philosophy curriculum. I just wanted to show you, without taking too much time, but a lot of students in Korea, they're very sleepy. Because they're up all night doing homework, or they go after school, they go for piano lessons, or violin, or to a tutor, or whatever. And we have a 5-minute break in the middle of class. We have a long, about an hour and a half class, and we have a 5-minute break in the middle. Well, they go to sleep for 4 minutes, and I've got to wake them up again. I have no discipline problems, I would say, virtually none, but I do have problems keeping them awake, because they stay up too late all the time. About a year and a half ago, the government said, okay, we've got a problem. There's too many kids going to school late at night. So they said, we're going to make a law, no school can be open after midnight. So guys, how would you like that? No school after midnight, that's a kind of encouragement. Okay? A lot of schools were open until 2 in the morning before that. So they clamped down on that. They realized that young people are under a lot of stress. Suicide rate is very, very high in Korea. Parents are pushing. You know, if you can't learn how to play the piano, or the violin, or the trombone, or whatever, you know, or if you can't learn your math, you can't learn your science, well, you better go to a tutor. You better go to after-school. So they come home, they have a bit of a bite to eat, they go off to school again. Then they got to come home to do their homework, things like that. So it's a problem. These are some of my care group guys. I'll just quickly tell you, Zach here on the left, his parents work for the embassy and American embassy. He got to meet President Obama this last fall. And he said it was kind of funny because, you know, he looks a lot like Obama. And he said, you know, he kind of looked at me for about 5 seconds, then he shook my hand. I said, well, Zach, if we ever have a movie about, you know, when Obama was young, I'll make sure you're in it. And Tom, next guy, he's Jewish. His father is the Israeli defense attaché in Seoul. Down below is Paul, he's Christian. And then Shoot, next to me, he's from India. He's a Christian boy, but his parents are not Christian. And Arnold, he would say, well, he's an agnostic, but I have seen things happening in his life over these 3 years. So anyway, these guys, that's kind of a, you know, mixed group that I have. And in my classes, I might have Buddhists and Hindus and Muslims in my Oasis classes, but also some Christians. And it gives me some great opportunities. We have a survey of world religions. Well, I have to, of course, respectfully talk about all the different religions, but I also come to Christianity then. So we respectfully talk about the key doctrines of Christianity. Who is Jesus? Why did he die on the cross? What are all his miracles about? And it's kind of a dialogue that I think is a healthy dialogue, provided it's done carefully and sensitively. I don't have too much time. Just to mention that those mission teams were wearing all different shirts depending on what country they were going to. I'll tell you one funny story though. Catherine went to Thailand this past year, and her shirt, it said redeemed in English, and then in the Thai script, it said redeemed, but the printer left off one dot by mistake, and so it actually said sinful chicken. And one of our Thai students, she said, that doesn't say redeemed, that says sinful chicken. And so they're all embarrassed. I mean, they went to the magic carpet and tried to put that dot back on. So you've got to be careful with the printers. But about a third of the school, high school, goes on a mission trip. They also do other things. There's lots of sports, and there's other kinds of school clubs, and Model United Nations, and chess, and speech and debate, and it just goes on. But the school is a busy, busy place. Catherine's in the orchestra, on soccer team, and cooking club, and all kinds of things. It's a busy school. Many of the international schools are really, really, you know, they want this prestige of look at how many things my kids are doing and all this. You know, they want a full experience, but sometimes they're too much. So, just to sum up, YIS is a very busy school, busy city. We have opportunities. We have windows of opening to share the gospel. Most of those students are there for 2 or 3 years, and that's it. We have a chance to work with them, which is plant those seeds that we pray the Lord will cause to blossom and come to fruit. Please pray for the discipleship of the school, Youngstown International School. That's the most important thing. I would say that's a real focus, that when they hear the word, it will go into their heart and really come to bear fruit. Students are students all over the world. They have very, very many similar ideas and needs and so forth. And, you know, that's the main thing, is that when we can, that we, of course, share the gospel. I picked this picture here on the left. It's kind of a crossroad. The idea of not only the cross in South Korea, but also the fact that, you know, there is tension between North and South. We pray for the North to open up, and we pray that the students themselves will not get caught up in materialism, but will really stay true and solid, and it needs prayer. Korea is definitely growing as a Christian country, but there's a lot of challenge as well. And this was our Father's Day picture back this summer here. Jordan on the left, he's 3 years at Redeemer College, and Ancaster has 2 more to go. And Carol, myself, and then Kaylin just finished her first year at Tyndale University down here in Toronto. And it's going to go for a few more years. And Catherine is with us. She's back in Korea for a couple more years, and then she will come back. And John from the right, he is a carpenter apprentice in Palmerston with his uncle, and also helping with worship in the church and helping with the little kids and so forth. So that is the family. Here are some links if you want to send us an email sometime. If you're interested in just our school, yissoul.org. If you're interested in the network of international Christian schools, down at the bottom, mix.org. And of course, if you want to send us an email, we'll be happy to answer your questions. We're going to break here, and I'll pray, and then you can talk to us if you'd like, and maybe you'd like to try one of these ginseng candies. But first impression, don't go by the first impression, just keep going for a while. It gets better. That's right. Heavenly Father, in these few minutes, as we've looked into the wonderful, wonderful, beautiful picture of the majestic temple that you are building, people from all over the world, tribes, tongue, nation, culture, all kinds of heritage, Lord, we realize that you are the one who is the cornerstone, the chief capstone, the foundation. There is no other. And Lord, we just pray that as we've thought about the Korean people tonight, that you'll just keep them upon our heart. Help us to pray for them, pray for both North and South Korea. Pray for the discipleship, the opportunities we have. Lord, help us to remember that we are missionaries, no matter where we are, what we do, as one of those living stones, that we are being fitted to your temple, and we're also making room and prayer for others to be fitted next to us. And we just pray that you'll also bless our fellowship time, the food we're about to receive, and the joy of the Lord that we share together. May it continue to abound here at this chapel here. We pray these things in Jesus' name. There was a school in Honduras, literally at the city dump. The school was at the city dump, about 100 kids at the dump school, and that's not uncommon in many third world nations. And so with our contacts in Honduras, we said, well, listen, we've got the school going here, the service project in Korea. Would you take the mission trip in March? They're already ready for what kind of things will arise from that. There's some of the high school students in the back here. With some of the soul speakers here, yes. We had a service project. I won't take too much time, but basically we were able to collect a lot of coins. They sent money to the Philippines, sent money to Honduras. We had a lot of contacts in Honduras. For the Christian students, discipleship, we use a lot of the same material that we would use in VBS here in Canada, and Wickless material, or Truth Quest, or others, so forth. There's also Soul Seekers, which is an after-school Bible club, which allows two things, not only for the students to have a little bit broader discipleship program with arts and crafts and games and so forth, kind of like a camp experience in some ways, but as well, the high school students who are going on a mission trip, they get to teach the Soul Seekers kids the program that they're going to take with them when they go on the mission trip. So, for instance, our mission teams go to the Philippines, or to China and so forth. Well, they'll have like a VBS type program and in Manila. And so what they do is they practice that material with the Soul Seeker kids in Korea. They kind of go through it and get used to it and all that. And then they go on the mission team.